a legend in hockey, a representative, torchbearer, India captain, ISB graduate, CEO of OGQ, multiple hat this gentleman wears. But for me, one question, Viren, for you is, how do you adapt what Deepa just now addressed and adjust yourself into different hat and different role and still strive? Because from playing to managing more than 130 top athletes to win a medal for India is a transition you chose by, it's by choice for you. How do you plan those strategies? How did you learn to apply what you learn on the field into your workplace? Because that is, for me, is the most curious question I would want to listen an answer from you.
Yeah. Good afternoon, everybody. Unlike what Deepa mentioned, I actually have no gratitude towards Nilesh. You see why he's bigger than me, taller than me, and stronger than me. So if I had to say no to come over here, he would have beaten me up. So I had to come over here, and I can't say no to Nilesh. But actually speaking, Nilesh and me go back a long way. We've been friends since a long time. And in a way, I would say sport and education are two of my passions. I've been privileged to get the opportunity to work in sport. Luckily, I have not worked in education because my teachers always threw me out of class in school and college. So so Nilesh is taking a big risk by trying to get me on stage and associated with a MBA course.
I would second that.
But all the management principle you guys have learned on the field and not in the classroom.
You know, to answer your question, I'll tell you a little story from my playing days where the coach of the Indian hockey team was a gentleman by the name of Cedric D'Souza. This was way back in around 2000, 2001. The Indian team was playing the Champions Trophy. And we were playing a match the next day against Australia. Australia, as you know, like in cricket and hockey, is a very strong team. And Cedric had introduced video analysis for us to prepare for matches at that time. And in video analysis, you watch your previous matches, you see strengths and weaknesses of your opponent, where you can exploit them, try to minimize our own errors. And, you know, we were all fighting to, Cedric told us to come to his hotel room in the night, the night before the match. We were all fighting to sit right behind. Because, you know, Cedric is a very strict coach. And when you see your mistakes on the big screen, you look like an idiot. And when Cedric plays it in slow motion, you look like a bigger idiot. So there we are, you know, we are dreading the dreaded pause button when Cedric would pause the and then he pauses it and he looks around for Mukesh Kumar. Mukesh Kumar, along with Dhanraj Pillai, used to be one of India's best strikers in the Indian team. So Cedric pauses the video and he tells Mukesh, Mukesh, aap itna senior experience khiladi hai, lekin apne itna bada galti kiya. So Mukesh looks at the screen and he says, kya ho gaya ko sab? So he says, Cedric says, dekho upar upar se saaf dikhai de rahe, gap to yahan pe tha, lekin apne pass wahan pe diya. So Mukesh looks at the video for some time and then he tells Cedric, kuch sab, ye camera kahan pe tha? So you know how it is in football, hockey, cricket, the camera's at a height to give you a bird's eye view of the ground. So Cedric says, camera to upar tha. So Mukesh again thinks for some time and, you know, then light dawns upon him. And then he says, coach sahab, jab Australia ke saath match khelte hai, agar upar se match dekha, to gap hi gap dikhte hai. Niche aake ground pe khelo na, gap hi nahi dikhte hai. And, you know, that was actually true. You're allowed to clap also. Because when I played against Australia around 25 times in my career. I was a center half, so I used to play in the middle of the ground, the thick of the action. And whenever I got the ball and I looked up, only the yellow shorts were visible. The blue shorts are not visible only. And it actually got me thinking, ki, are we training right? Are we preparing right? And are we preparing with the quality and intensity that we had to prepare for international matches? The answer was sadly no. But, you know, and Cedric is the finer 1,000 rupees also if the cell rang during the thing. So maybe we can find Tarun today. But yeah, to answer your question, I think I've just always liked to keep things very simple in life and just go to the ground level, roll up the sleeves and figure out what are the problems. And then, like Deepa said, find solutions to problem. I think just a positive attitude and keep things as simple as possible. That's been one of the critical things. And I think sport teaches you that. It teaches you to, I've definitely lost much more than I've won in life. So, but I can definitely say I've learned a lot from my defeats. I've not learned too much from my victories.
Actually, I think that's one of the key factors. He very rightly mentioned one critical point, that he's failed more, but he learned from these failures. I think in life, you need to be candid enough in accepting your failures to step a stone for a winning.